Hello, everybody, and welcome back to In the Mix. Again, my name is Chris Famularo, and joining me today is my wonderful sister, Emily Famularo. She is the creator and owner of The Hook magazine. She is also a writer and a current graduate student at Emerson University. And today, she has given us the honor of curating her own playlist, of which that she will be going over, and hopefully you all enjoy. So, Emily, thank you for coming on, and take it away.
Thank you for having me on here. I'm so excited about this. We both love music a ton, so I was really stoked to be part of this episode, especially after the success of the first video. So hopefully my playlist lives up to the hype.
Well, thank you very much. I'm excited for it.
So for my playlist, I focused on a collaborative kind of outlook of songs from hip hop, you know, rap to dance, electronic, indie, alternative rock, things like that. I really tried to keep it interesting for every kind of viewer. So I started my playlist with You and Me by The Magician. The Magician is typically a dance artist. It's from their Renaissance singles, like little EP, which was released in 2020. I love this song. And I placed it first because I think it really sets out where this playlist is headed. It's going to be fun. It's going to be emotional sometimes. It's going to be very dancey, very moody, which is really like my listening aesthetic. So You and Me specifically, the song feels very pure to me. Like it should play during one of those, you know, movie montages where the two leads finally realize they're into each other at the basement house party of their dreams. I just love how physical this song makes me feel, and just how amped up I get listening to it. My next track that I chose is Tangerine by Glass Animals. Glass Animals are one of my favorite bands. They're indie pop, I would describe them as. And this song in particular is from their 2020 release, Dreamland. It's a full-length album. I like Glass Animals especially because they really utilize electronic aspects of music to inspire their indie rock kind of style. This song specifically uses a lot of layover of sounds you might hear in video games or things like that. Their newest album, as I mentioned, Dreamland, takes from 2014's Zaba and 2016's How to Be a Human Being in like this perfect coalescent way. And I just love how they utilize all of those different sounds from both of the albums, Zaba being much more vibey, and How to Be a Human Being as much more electronic. And while the music itself is really poppy, which you'll hear, I mean like poppy, like pop music, it's actually pretty sad. The lyrics are about, you know, kind of falling out of it with someone, which I think Glass Animals always does really well. It's like depressing music for people who want to be happy. Are you stuck in your own way? I'm begging. The third track I chose was Mood featuring Ian Dior by 24K Golden. It's a 2020 single, hip hop rap kind of genre. But a lot of people really talk down on mainstream music, but I think this track is really, really good. And I think 24K Golden is like onto something very spectacular. After finding this song, I listened to their 2019 EP, Dropped Out of College, and it just, their mood is just fun. It's a lot of fun. It doesn't take itself too seriously, and it utilizes rap over a guitar sound, which gives it an automatic flow, you know, to kind of bounce around to. And this song specifically reminds me of summer, of, you know, wanting to party. I mean, not in the time of COVID, but at some point, maybe one day, we will party once more and not take anything too seriously. Life is fun, and I think this song does a really good job of just having fun. When I started feeling attached, somehow I was in a feeling bad. Maybe I am not your dad. So we're in the hip hop you know, rap section of my list. I thought it was really important to include hip hop and rap because it's a genre that's doing a lot of work lately. And I would describe Revenge by rapper Snot, dollar sign N-O-T, as indie rap. It's smooth, the chorus is emotional, and the lyrics are really trying to identify with being a person who sometimes finds themselves as not the best version. You know, they could be a better person. And I think that this track really does that. It's so heavy, so lonely, but it wants to change. It wants to be better. And I like that the song keeps it real. And I also love the way Snot raps. So smooth. You know, there's never a moment of pause. It's just a constant streamline. And I think that is really interesting in the genre of rap.
What is rose? I know. I had to draw that bitch off. Nigga, why you talking? Well, I think that shit's song.
My fifth song is Make It Happen by Chef and Sleepy Hollow. It's a 2020 release off of Just For Y'all, which is an EP. It's, again, hip hop and rap. This is going to be a more standard rap track. But I first heard this song from a car in the park across the street from our apartment. They were just blasting it. And I immediately fell in love with it. It's such a different rap track to me because it focuses so much on making it. You know, they did make it happen. Here they are fulfilling their dreams, and it's so uplifting, and I really appreciate this track for all of the things it's doing for its genre, but also generally off of this EP. This is a super personal EP about how hard it is to stay focused in making art and achieving that goal, and I think they really did that. You know, chef's kiss to this song.
Say, look at me now, bitch, I'm making it happen. Bitch, I'm making it happen. I was on love and smiles when they see me. They wanna be me, tell them to fuck them.
So my last track that is going to be hip-hop rap is Motley Crue by They. It's off their 2017 album, New Religion, Hyena. I actually first heard this song at Firefly in 2018 when they performed. It filled me with so much emotion, and I think that this track especially is really relevant right now in the current climate, you know, of racial justice that we are trying to achieve and politics and everything going on. You know, this song comes straight from the heart, very guttural. I like how choppy it is. And I think that the chorus especially really ties the whole song together. So I definitely had to include it in this playlist.
Some might say we're armed and dangerous. Pay the price of the life every night, but it ain't enough.
Moving on into a little bit of a different genre is Vision Color by Milk and Bone and Alex Lustig. It's off of their Dive EP, which was released in 2019. I mean, this song reminds me straight up of San Juan Apiro, the episode of Black Mirror. What a great song. It's contemporary. It could fit in any era. And I just love how moody and melodic this song is. I love it for driving, for crying, for walking with purpose. It makes me feel badass. And I love this whole EP in general, but this song especially has always stuck out to me. Following in the vein of women in music, I have number 8 is Rue by Girl in Red. It's a single recently Keeping in track with women in music, I have Rue as my number 8 song for this playlist by Girl in Red. It's a 2020 release, bedroom pop, alt pop, but Girl in Red has always impressed me from their very first EP release, Chapter 1, in 2018. She actually creates all of her music in her bedroom, which I think is really cool. This song, especially, like many Girl in Red tracks, is so, so good. The progression of the chords alone in time with the lyrics force a sense of looming emotion of having to hurt someone that you don't want to hurt, but you know that you have to because that's what is right. So it's such an incredible song, and it really explores itself, which is really cool. And if you like it, then you definitely need to listen to Chapter One. So I've talked with you, Christopher, about Caribou a ton. Mm-hmm. I love Caribou. So of course Caribou had to make this list with their track You and I. It's off of their 2020 release, Suddenly. It's going to be what I describe indie electronic, but Caribou has always really, really impressed me with their quasi-electronic sound that they create. It takes on qualities of indie music, that whispering vocal, and introduces it to more typical elements of electronic and dance, you know, repetition, things like that. This song is so ethereal to me. I feel like it's always raining when it plays, but the kind of rain that you're looking forward to, like that feeling of newness after, you know, a shower or a good cry or something like that. So we're gonna get a little bit more upbeat with The Sun by Mid. It's a 2017 single off of their collection called All Inclusive Singles. It's considered, I would say, still indie electronic, but this song is gonna be so catchy. It's upbeat, it's great for cardio if you're into listening to music while working out. Mid typically features on other tracks, so to get their own is really neat because usually they're creating the beats for other artists. While this single is from 2017, it reminds me a lot of what Caribou is doing now in 2020, right? It's like, I would describe this song as, and I've never been to California, but I feel like it's like driving along a California coast with the windows down and this song is playing, it's golden hour. It's such a vibe. I've loved it ever since the first time I heard it. I admit, in this very short video of playlist songs, that I do have a song to take selfies to, as anyone should, obviously, to get hyped up. And that song for me is Imaginary Friend by M.O. It's a 2018 release from their album Forever Neverland. I think it's really upbeat, it's tender, it's following that trend of less than perfect vocals. I also think it exhibits a perfect drop, you know, that drop in music. And for me, this is one of the most satisfying drops, if I do say so. And it's got this great overlay about 2 minutes and 30 seconds in that really helps escalate the song naturally. It falls at that point, and then that overlay really brings it back to a natural climactic moment again, which is just really awesome. And I love this song. It inspires me to take beautiful selfies. So. Just watch me with your hands. I have also included for my 12th song the most perfect dance song, which is Ride It by Regard. It's a 2019 single. Much like You and Me by The Magician from earlier in the playlist, it is repetitive, like most dance music, but the beat is the best part. That repetition is the best part because you feel it. It makes you want to move. Another great montage song that will definitely be in my memoir-based film about my life. A few of the tracks on this playlist have actually been inspired by Letterkenny, and this song especially was inspired by that show, Do It, Try It by M83. It's off their 2016 full-length Junk. How else, you know, to follow Ride It than with another dance song? But this is an incredible song. As I said, I first heard this song in Canadian television show called Letterkenny, which is now on Hulu. And no spoilers, but it's from this really intense scene. And I love to talk to the person who scores that show. I mean, the sheer emotion in this song, right? It's just so infused with dance and letting yourself go, feel the beat and dancing it out. M83 does a really great job of creating this cinematic quality about their work, which, you know, some people know M83 from a few years ago, but what they're doing more recently is even better. So I love this track for, again, working out, you know, cardio, or feeling things emotionally. I'm gonna move into a more indie pop phase for my playlist. A track that I really wanted to share was Can I Call You Tonight by Dayglow. It's a 2018 release from their full-length Fuzzy Brain. I think that Fuzzy Brain perfectly describes what these songs feel like. Dayglow is so cute as a band, as a whole. I love this song because it makes me think of, you know, when I was single and stuck on a crush, trying to navigate what it's like to like someone and to be worried about if they're hearing you, if they're into you, if you're into them, all of those kinds of things. And I just love this song. I'm super happy to be able to include The Neighborhood's latest album, Chip Chrome and the Monotones, which was just released in 2020. I, as Christopher knows, am the biggest Neighborhood fan. And their last release in 2018 was nothing that I wanted. And this latest release is like their old mixtapes and their claim to fame, which was 2015's Wiped Out, which includes songs like, you know, Daddy Issues and things like that. I love this song so much. It's breathy. The Neighborhood is just so cool to me. I love listening to them because I'm cool, bipartisan for listening. It's like walking down the street in leather pants and everyone's looking at you like, dang, they're a badass for wearing leather pants, which I wouldn't wear leather pants, but I like this song. So number 16 on my playlist is the oldest track on this list. It's from The Drums' 2011 full-length album, Portamento. I think this song is amazing. I just discovered it. Ryan made me a playlist, and this was one of the songs on the playlist. And it's so cute. It never takes itself too seriously, which is something that The Drums are very good at. And if you've never heard The Drums, they do this weird thing where they kind of sound like they're from the 50s mixed with alt rock from the 90s. So I've been obsessing over this track. I love the riff, I love the vocals, I love how fast it feels, like it's out of breath with so much still to say. And, you know, the chorus is, I want to buy you something, but I don't have any money, and I don't have any money either, so I really resonate with this track. I've been writing for the hook for a very long time, and as of right now, it's not in the forefront of my things that I'm doing, but it is still something that I deeply care about. And I had to mention one of the best bands that I've ever had the opportunity to review, work with, watch, play, and listen to. That's Halogens, you know, New Jersey natives. Their track Buckle is the track that I'm including in this playlist. It's 2019. Release off of their Happy Hour EP. It's going to be indie alt rock. It's definitely got the vibe of underground music, basement style sound, But halogens, it truly boggles my mind how they aren't the biggest thing since sliced bread. I mean, they encompass aspects of that scene that I was talking about, rock, alternative, and indie sounds. And not to mention, all of the tracks are gutting. I mean, just absolutely perfect tracks. This song is my favorite next to Kitchen Sink from their previous EP. They're working on new music right now, which I'm so excited for, but I think they appeal to a lot of different music lovers because they are a part of so many kind of little genres and they work their asses off, so I had to include them.
Just like me to be just like you. Apparently leaves a piece of themselves in you.
The second to last track on my playlist is from the best name band in the entire world, which is Sports. I mean, what a great name for a band. Cadillac is their 2018 track released on Everyone's Invited. I would say they're indie pop. It's another timeless song, you know, thinking about Vision Color from earlier, which reminds me of any era of contemporary music. It utilizes dance and electronic sounds to formulate a beat. The vocals are laid over it in this like methodic repetition. The song itself makes me want to just feel everything in the world. I can take it all on because the song is there to back me up. It makes me want to dance, and I listen to this song a lot again while walking and doing cardio because it does have that really nice beat that you can fall in line with as you go. All right, we've made it to my last track, number 19. This is gonna be Anemone by Slender Bodies. It's a 2017 release off their Fabulous EP. I think Slender Bodies is so good, and I wanted them to be last because I truly believe they encompass every aspect of every song that I've talked about. First off, sorry, I was just so overcome by how much I love Slender Bodies. First off, Slender Bodies is doing really, really cool stuff within their genre, and generally, you need to check their stuff out. If you like Anemone, you're gonna love everything else that they put out. We, Ryan and I, saw them play in Cambridge, Massachusetts, and my gosh, it was surreal. All of their music, I would describe as, it's like listening to it underwater, but I like that. You're just floating there. It's so calming. The constant of knowing, you know, like the tide is always going to come to shore. There's always going to be sunsets and sunrises. The song makes me feel like everything is going to be okay. I love listening to it when I feel anxious or when I need time to decompress. I mean, we're living in a super hostile period of time, and it's important to find music that really helps you get back to your center. And that's a really big reason why I listen to music in general, because it grounds us. It sets us back into ourselves to take a pause, to feel something and figure it out. And that's what all of these tracks do for me. So I hope after listening to Anemone, you will feel the same.
And that does it for Emily's playlist of In the Mix. Emily, thank you so much for coming on. I mean, I listened to this playlist just last night when you sent it to me for the first time. I think it is such a good, easy listen. I love the first track that is on here. It's such a good, dancey vibe that really enters you into the realm of your musical sphere of what you really enjoy, and it really embodies your whole aura as a person. I think a lot of people are going to enjoy this. I hope plenty of you enjoy the music, enjoy the video. Emily, is there anything else you wanted to say?
Oh, thank you for having me. I hope everyone has a great time listening. Please reach out if you really resonate with any of these tracks. I love to talk about music, and I can't wait to share this video with the people of The Hook, who will also be super stoked on this whole In the Mix playlist thing. So,
and I will make sure to put both of our socials in the video as well. So if you are interested in any of the songs, or Emily as a whole as a music curator, or as an artist, you can reach out to her. I'll have Twitter and Instagram available, even though I think your Twitter handle may not be very not safe
PC
for work,
buddy.
But not very PC buddy, but I'll make sure it gets in there, or it'll be in the YouTube the YouTube description. But thank you, Emily, so much. It's always a pleasure talking about music with you. I'm sure down the line, once we get a lot of other people hopefully on the show, I'm sure you'll be back to curate some more music for us. Thank you as well for watching this video. If you liked the last one where I did my previous playlist just by myself, I hope you enjoyed that one. Thank you so much for subscribing. If you enjoyed this video, like it. If you didn't like it, dislike it. If you have something to say, comment down below. Please subscribe if you can to One Shot Entertainment. And thank you so much, and have a great rest of your day.